None of them not there for me level. I'm not even, I know how I do it. I just do it like Jordan or Ewing or Shaquille or Kobe, and no one can
say. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, empresslika. And today I'm going to be showing you guys this purple clay from Mo Feng Jiang. I believe that's how you pronounce it. The link for it will be below. I got it off of Amazon for like $9. So I'm going to be showing you guys me putting it in. I'm just going to kind of talk to you guys a little bit about it and what I thought about it. So for one, you want to really make sure that you kind of start from the bottom. I didn't do that initially. So start from the tips and work your way up. Just make sure you're rubbing it in really good, and don't be cheap with the amount of clay that you use. If you have my length, then one bottle should be more than enough. But if you do have longer hair, like much longer hair, I would recommend getting maybe two containers instead of one. So one thing that I really loved about this product is that the color is really vibrant. It did a really good job of covering my natural hair. As you can see, my hair is really dark, so I really like that. The next thing that I really liked about this product is I just felt like you really can't beat having a product that allows you to change your hair color without having to actually permanently change it or dye or bleach your hair. You know, some of us don't want to go through that process and put our hair through that, so this clay definitely was a big plus for that in my book. Now, one thing that I didn't like about this clay is it's very messy. Okay, definitely know that for the first 2 to 3 days it will get on everything. It will get all on your clothes, it will get all in your fingers, and fingers you have to be careful with too, because you might touch it and then forget and then touch something else. It will get on your pillowcases, so I would recommend wrapping your hair. I mean, you should wrap your hair at night anyways, but if you don't, I would recommend wrapping it while you have this clay in. You know, it's just really, really messy. But I do feel like after the third day, it definitely seemed to get to a point where it was so dry that most of it didn't really smudge off or come off on my fingers and off on my clothes, but you still had a little bit, so you want to be careful with that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you guys how the rest of it came out. Okay, so I finished my whole head, and I must say that this color is just really bright and vibrant. I love this purple so much. I'm gonna come a little closer to the camera so that you guys can see, because from afar it doesn't look that bright, but this color is just really vibrant and defined. I just really enjoy this clay and this color. I'm going to be doing the styles that you guys seen in the thumbnail next, so after I show you this, we'll be getting started on that. Okay, so I'm back, and in this first style, this is actually one of my favorite. The only thing that you're going to be doing is taking out two pieces of hair on both sides in the front, and then you're just going to be throwing the rest of your hair in a regular ponytail. Since this is the ponytail edition, all of these styles are going to be really easy and really quick. If you want to add more hair out, you can. I only added two, but I just love this style so much because it just really gives me this anime slash Meishan from The Walking Dead type of feel. Like, I just need a samurai so I can start slicing and dicing. Like, that's how this hairstyle makes me feel, and I really like it. So after you put in a ponytail, you have your first style.
Shit we can do. You free to say whatever, baby, if you asking me. No limit when I'm in it, got a masterpiece. I'm hoping I don't have a fast release. Got me focused like I'm out here trying to get my master seat. Throwing other piece out.
Okay, for this next style, it's also going to be really easy. I mean, all of them are really easy. You're just going to be parting some hair to the side like as if you're doing a swoosh bang. This is also one of my favorite because even before I lock my hair, I love a good swoosh bang. I'm also leaving a lock out on each side, but you don't have to. I mean, when I'm done with the style, I'm actually going to end up tucking it in. But I mean, if you like it, you can wear it like that. So once you get your hair off to the side that you're going to kind of tuck in, just put your hair in a regular ponytail. And the ponytail doesn't have to be too tight. Don't make it too tight. And then you're going to take this hair, and I would really recommend using a bobby pin if you can, because I just kind of felt like mine looked a little lumpy. But what I did was I took my locks and just kind of like pushed them in between some locks that were in the back over there. Okay, these kind of fell out, so I'm going to go ahead and stick these and tuck those over too. I'm just kind of like I said, sticking them in the back of some of the locks that are back there in the ponytail. And this is how it looked when I'm done. And like I said, if you don't like the two locks out on the side, you can always just kind of pull them up and put them into the ponytail. I was a little undecided, but I decided to go up and put them up. Okay, so on this third style, what you're going to be doing is separating your hair. You just want to take a little bit of the middle and then leave some even size out on both ends. Now, don't take too much because you don't want the braid to be too big. Like, maybe take like 4 rows of locks, and then you're just going to braid going backwards. And after you braid it, you're going to separate the hair from in the front into the two sections on each side, and then you're going to put the rest in a ponytail. Now, if you want to combine all of it together, you can, but I didn't combine all of my hair in a ponytail together because I felt like what it would do is kind of like make it look like the locks on the side were also combined into the locks on the braids, or as if they were supposed to go with the braid in the middle. And that's not what I wanted. I really wanted you to be able to tell, like, okay, this braid is in the middle and this side locks is just kind of laying back going backwards on their own on both sides, if that makes sense. So right here, what I'm going to be doing is I'm going to just kind of lay it flat backwards, and I'm just going to tuck it into the back of the ponytail. And I like this method because it also gave me a little extra length, so it kind of gave my ponytail a little bit more fullness, and it made it look like I had a little bit more length in the back because I tucked this in the back of the ponytail. And you do the same thing on the other side, and then you have your style number 3. Just fix it up a little bit if it's looking a little crazy like this. I'm going to fix it up. And there is the finished product. Okay, so for the last hairstyle, what you're going to be doing is sectioning your hair off into 2 parts in the front, and then you're just braiding it going backwards. You're just doing 2 braids. Like I've told you in my previous videos, what I would recommend is making sure that you evenly take however amount that you have in that first row and then braid going backwards. I mean, it's up to you, but sometimes the lock braids can look a little funny if you just kind of start braiding from a corner, or if you start braiding, you know, from the edges, if you don't braid kind of going straight back. So I would be careful with that, but you're just doing 2 braids. So as you can see, I'm putting a braid in on this side. You also, again, want to try to make it flat if you can, because you don't want it to look too lumpy. But if you can't, I mean, it's okay. It's a quick, easy, cute hairstyle regardless. I'm going to just kind of put that in a little mini ponytail for now. And I'm going to do the other side, and I'm going to show you guys how it looks when it's done.
Got me focused like I'm out here trying to get my master seat. Throwing up the peace sign, girl, I'm from the east side. Girl, you on my best side, but she from the west side.
Okay, this is how it looked after I put in a ponytail. I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. And feel free to leave a comment below if you have any questions. You can also DM me on my Instagram. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.
I do wanna know, don't you sugarcoat, I say it all.